Hello and welcome to Achievers Hive. Today we are going to talk about types of problems in psychology and also the characteristics of difficult problems. But before that, I want to raise a question here. What is a problem? So we can say that a problem is a set of complex situations that requires a solution, right? Or that needs to be solved. Also, if I ask a question, what is problem solving? So we can say solving a problem means finding a way out of difficulty, right? So this is problem and a problem solving. This is what we discussed. We come across a lot of problems in our daily life. Too many problems we face throughout the day, like some physical problems, some environmental issues, some personal problems, some career related problems. So there are so many types of problems that we can say that the types of problems are numerous, right? But in psychology, when we have to define the types of problems, we talk about mainly two types of problems. One is ill-defined problem and another is well-defined problem. Ill-defined problems and well-defined problems are the two types of problems which are considered in psychology. So today we'll talk about these two types of problem in detail and also the characteristics of difficult problems. So if we talk about a well-defined problem, it is a problem that has a clear solution, you know, a clear way of solution, a clear way of finding its answer. For example, a maths question, a maths problem comes under this kind of problem, that is a well-defined problem. Because in a mathematical problem, we may have, you know, a numerous way to solve a problem, but still they will be definite, right? Also, we know how to solve it when this situation arises, when we can say how the solution will be done, then the problem will come under this well-defined problem. One more example we can take. Suppose we have to convert an active voice to a passive voice, right? So we know how, what is the process of converting an active voice to a passive voice. So the process, the formula, the method will be followed for the same. And for every time it will be done the same, right? So these kind of problems are well-defined problems. But in ill-defined problems, there is, no way of finding a solution is available. For example, how to be happy, you know, how to have a command on psychology, how to have a command on mathematics. There you have to, you know, think a lot from where to start and how to start. When this kind of situation arrives, we can say that the problems are ill-defined, whose solution is not clear. We are not, you know, clear from where to start and how to do it, you know. There can be different ways for each and every person. I may try to solve the same problem in some other way, and you may also try to solve the same problem in a different way. So today, I'll be explaining a little more about these two. And we will also be discussing about the categories of well-defined problems. There are three categories. So we will talk one by one, and then after we will move to the, you know, the characteristics of difficult problems. So this is all we are going to talk about. So with the help of this picture, let us understand more about ill-defined and well-defined problems. Let's begin. As we have discussed, there are two types of problems. One is well-defined problems and another one is ill-defined problems. Well-defined problems or well-structured problems and ill-structured problems, these two can be understood very easily with the help of these pictures. See, well-structured problems have a clear path to the solution. We can reach to the solution very easily as these are well-defined. Whereas in the ill-structured problems, the dimensions of problems are not specified. Well-structured problems, example can be maths problem, anagrams, active voice, passive voice, these kind of problems can be well-structured problem, whereas ill-structured problems are what? Finding an apartment, writing a book, getting proficiency in a particular subject, in which you have to think from where to start and how to start, right? So you have to think about the whole process, then it comes under ill-structured problems. In a well-defined problem, both the nature of the problem and the information needed to solve it are available and clear. Thus, one can make straightforward judgments about whether a potential solution is appropriate or not. Within ill-defined problems, such as how to bring peace,
you know, how to write a book. Not only may the specific nature of the problem be unclear, the information required to solve the problem may be even less obvious. With the help of this picture, we can easily compare these two now. See, in the well-structured problems, these are straightforward, familiar, they're easily defined. They can be defined easily. Their solution can also be obtained very easily. So we can say that we are clear in solving these kind of problems. Whereas when we talk about ill-structured problems, these are new or unusual, right? They are ambiguous information they give, or they have incomplete information. So in these kind of problems, we have to find out the edges to this kind of problem. We have to first, you know, find out from what to start and where to start. This kind of situation arises in ill-structured problem. Now, we'll talk about Greenough, who was a scientist, who was a psychologist. In 1978, he suggested one method of classifying well-defined problems based on the general kind of psychological skills and knowledge which is needed to solve different problems. Typically, well-defined problems fall into one of these three categories. And these three categories are: first is arrangement, second is inducing the structure, and the third is transformation. So we will begin with the arrangement. One by one, we'll go for all these three. Arrangement of problem requires that the problem solver must rearrange or recombine elements in a way that will satisfy a certain criteria. Usually, several different arrangements can be made, but only one or few arrangements will produce a solution. For example, one can say that anagrams problems or jigsaw problems are examples of arrangement problems, in which in these we have to first of all arrange, then we come to the solution. Now, coming to the inducing structure. In these kind of problems, a person must identify the existing relationship among the elements presented. He then should construct a new relationship among them so that the problem could be solved. You know, inducing structure, that means you have to induct something. In such a problem, the problem solver must determine not only the relationships among the structures, but also the structure and the size of the elements involved. So these are inducing structure problem. Now, coming to the third type of problems, that they are transformation problems. As the word says, transformation, we'll get to know what these problems are. In these problems, an attempt is made to change the initial state to a goal state, that means to its final state. According to Greenough, what Greenough said in 1978, solving transformation problems primarily requires skills in planning based on a method which is called means-end analysis. This means-end analysis requires identifying differences that exist between the current state and the goal state and selecting operations that will reduce these differences. So this was what said in the transformation problem, that the transformation must be made from the initial state to a goal state. So these were the three categories of these well-defined problems. Now we'll be talking about the characteristics of difficult problems. So let us understand some of the typical characteristics we are going to talk about now for the difficult problems. One of them is intransparency. That there is lack of clarity of the situation. The situation which is given to us, that will not have the clear situation, that will not be clear to us. So this is the characteristic of a difficult problem. Second is commencement's opacity. You will be having confusion regarding how to start or state the problem. We will not be clear about this. So this is one of the characteristic of it. Next, we are coming to continuation opacity. You know, we will be continuing with the confusion which we already are having in the beginning. We will be continuing with that in regarding to the problem as there is no clarity. So continuation opacity is one of the characteristic. Then we come to the polytely, you know, contradiction in the goals. The problem has multiple goals, and so reaching and selecting a particular goal becomes difficult. We will also be not able to find out that through which goal we will reach our destination. That would also be, you know, difficult for us. So that is one of the characteristic of a difficult problem. Next is inexpressiveness in the problem. You know, the problem will itself be not explaining it. Inability to express the problem clearly. until unless we will not be clear with the problem, how would we find out the solution, right? So that would be the problem in this. Opposition, the problem will itself be creating an opposition kind of situation. So we will not be clear with that, and then it becomes a characteristic of difficult problem. Then we can say transience, the problem keeps changing, you know, that lasts for a short time. That creates a trouble for a researcher or for a problem solver to solve it. So that becomes its characteristic. Complexity, the problem is in large number of items, too many interrelationship and decisions. You know, too much of complexity inside the problem. The interrelation of the terms used, of the, you know, whatever content it has, it will be interconnected with too many interrelationship it will be having. So that decision making problem will be arriving, and so we will not be able to find out the solution of it. Innumerability, we cannot, it is not possible to list it or quantify it. It is, you know, cannot be counted, so that will create a trouble. So it becomes a characteristic of difficult problem. Connectivity problem, there are hierarchy of problems in relation to a relationship, communication and location. Then we come to the heterogeneity. The problem is not homogeneous and so difficult to handle. It will be heterogeneous problem. It will be having a lot of stuff inside, a lot of confusion inside. So that would become a heterogeneous kind of problem. Dynamics, we are not sure about the time. Time considerations will be taken, but still we are not sure about the time. See, next, the temporal constraint says there is limitation to time factor. It has to be got done without it within a time period. So in a time period, it has to be done. Still, we are not sure. So the dynamics and temporal constraints becomes its characteristic of a difficult problem. Temporal sensitivity. The problem is influenced and affected by time factor. This is what the same thing we can say. Somewhere it is, it has to be done within a time period. It is bound with the time. So we can say the temporal sensitivity is one of the problem. Phase effects. There are changes in different phases of the problem, and these affect the problem from being solved. So the problem keeps on changing, we can say. Dynamic unpredictability. The problem is complex and consists of high degree of unpredictability. So that becomes a trouble for a problem solver to solve the problem. So these are the characteristics of difficult problems.
So it was all about types of problems and characteristics of difficult problems. So I hope it has helped you. If you like this video, then do like and also subscribe to our channel for more such stuff. Stay connected, keep watching. Thank you. Bye.